Hello students, welcome to JRF with Riya. In this video, we are going to discuss about the coastal geomorphologies, depositional landforms and classification of shorelines. Significant depositional landforms developed by sea waves include sea beaches, bars and barriers, offshores and longshore bars, spits, hooks, loops, connecting bars, looped bars, tombolo, barrier island, tidal inlets, winged headlands, progression, wave-built platform, etc. So first is beaches. Temporary or short-lived depositions of marine sediments consisting of sands, shingles, cobbles, etc. on the seashore are called beaches. According to A. Bloom in 1979, the sediment in motion along a shore is the beach. Beaches are deposited by breaker waves between high and low tide water. Beaches are in fact wedge-shaped sediments deposits on seashore. In width, beaches vary from a few meters to several kilometers. Beaches are generally formed when sea is calm and winds are of low velocity. An ideal beach consists of two main elements, upper beach and lower beach, and several minor elements, storm beach, beach ridges or bumps, beach cusps, small channels, ripples and runnels, etc. Here are the beach profile you can see. The upper beach representing the landward section of the beach is composed of coarser and larger materials such as pebbles, cobbles and boulders, and the slope ranges between 10 degree to 20 degree. On the other hand, the lower beach representing the seaward section of the beach is composed of sand and has low gradient of 2 degree or even less. The storm beach is a semi-permanent ridge which stands well above the level of highest spring tides. The successive low ridges built by constructive waves parallel to the coastline and below the level of high spring tides are called beach ridges or bumps. Beach cusps are small regular embayment and a series of headlands composed of shingles. Sand ripples are developed on the lower beach section by wave action or by tidal currents. Beaches are generally classified on the basis of beach material into sand beach, shingle beach and boulder beach. The sand beach, sand grains ranging from ranging in size between 0.5 to 2 mm, and in single beach composed of pebbles ranging in size of 2 to 100 mm, and in boulder beach more than 100 mm in diameter. The regular increase in the width of sea beaches towards the sea is called progradation, while depletion of beaches due to erosion and thus either narrow or beach cutting is called retrogradation. Okay, now come on to the bars and barriers and associated features. Embankments or mounds of sands formed by sedimentation through sea waves parallel to the shoreline are called bars. There are different forms of sandbars and barriers. If the bars are formed in such a way that they are parallel to the coast but are not attached to the land, they are called offshore or longshore bars. If the sandbars are formed in such a way that their one end is attached to the land while the other end projects or open out towards the sea, they are called spits. High energy storm waves very often modify the shape of spits by bending them towards the coast. The curved spits assume the shape of hook and thus such spits are called hook spits. Here are the different types of bars and barriers. Okay. When the opposing currents become more dominant than the littoral currents, the spits are bent to much extent that they are attached to the mainland and they formed complete loop which enclose seawater in the form of lagoon. Such form of a spit is called loop. When such loop is formed around an island, it is called looped bar. Connecting bars are formed bars are so extended that they either join two headlands or two islands. A bar becomes tombolo when it connects the mainland with an island or connects the headland with the island. When bars of pebbles and cobbles are formed on either side of a headland, such headlands are called winged headlands. Now come on to the classification of coast and shore lines. There is a wide range of variations in opinion in relation to types and classification of coastlines and shore lines. Not only this, there is also differences of opinions regarding the meaning and definitions of coastlines and shorelines, as some scientists treat them separately while some take them as synonyms. The meaning of sea coast and seashore has already been explained in the part 1 video of coastal morphology. The Johnson's classification of shoreline. D.W. Johnson in 1990 presented a genetic classification of shorelines, wherein he divided shorelines into four main types on the basis of nature of coastland before changes in sea level, whether the coastline was upland and lowland before change in sea level, and emergence or submergence of shoreline due to sea level change, as follows. The first is shoreline of emergence. Shoreline of emergence is formed due to changes in sea level, either due to fall in sea level in relation to coastline or upheaval of coastland in relation to sea level. The next is shoreline of submergence. This is formed because of submergence of coastal land due to rise in sea level, either due to climatic changes or tectonic movement. There are two types of submerged shoreline. First is rear shoreline, formed in mouth of a river, and next is fjord shoreline, formed on glacial traps. And the next is neutral shoreline. These are formed neither by emergence nor by submergence, because they do not have reveal any such evidence which can prove emergence or submergence. And the next is compound shoreline. These are characterized by the evidences of both submergence and emergence. Okay, that's all for this session. Thank you for watching. Keep watching and keep learning.